Boom. And then, there's a racetrack over there too. This is a museum. Right next to the raceway. There is a store with just shirts, but I don't care. Man, this is nice. This is just the art. Wow, this is nice. When you're in Talladega, Alabama, get a chance to visit this place. There's some pretty newer cars, Paul Juniors. 500 to win that. Awesome, dude. Man. Eat them all, bro.
Oh, there's an autograph. I mean, a race version Dale car there. Mm-hmm.
This is nice, bro. Nice cars. You got some of Gordon's. This is Indy Wind.
Down there.
It's got this cobbler. It's Atlanta Wind. His first one for Joe Gibbs Racing. Yeah. Chase Elliott's.
There's.
You got a lot of cars.
Ooh, KB's first win for Joe Gibbs. Harvick race vert, well, autograph there.
Awesome, bro.
I really like that.
Yeah, this is the entire ones.
There's the one you were talking about, that Harvick World Tree car.
That's the one I want, bro. Dang, give it to me. Dang, I got money. Country. This is Earnhardt Country. Diecast up here. I don't have a clue if they're selling these. But nope, not for sale. But these are some pretty nice ones here. And a little one. Ooh. Shoot. That's just a wild.
See that Earnhardt Wrangler there?
Nice, bro. Get some of the shirts there.
2010
Daytona race version from
the
Bush here. There's a Wall
Trip and Steve Park. Right up
the 124 of that. Wall
Trip, man. Wow.
I wish I could buy some of these, man.
I have the 160 for that.
Especially
one.
This one.
When's that the 160 for that? The old championship car. I have the race version of that.
I want to buy this. It's $28 though, but I want to buy that.
What is Dale Jr.'s Daytona race version?
Look at this.
They have Dale's
case
last
here.
One. Last one race version.
You can just. Oh, that's just perfect.
It's like 2%
perfect diecast in here, man. Jeez, I need some.
Oh, there's the 164, Dale's last win.
Dale's final win in there.
Oh, they have some trucks.
Collection. This is the one I want right here.
Oh.
So badly.
Please. Oh, Hammond. Wolford want that.
Look at every section. And visually here. One.
One for each one on you.
Yes, ma'am.
Look at this Ernie Irvin car though.
Give me a
minute. It's an Oldsmobile.
Oh, there's a big one.
Wow.
Notice that one.
I like this Kurt. It's that Kurt Busch there.
There's some stuff up there too that I want to get a video of it. YouTube.
See, this
YouTube.
Is what I...
Bro, that is awesome right there. Earnhardt.
There's the champagne bottle from 2008. Talladega.
Over. Your big old head's in the way.
There's some trophies and some...
Here's where the diecast come out. There's a piece of the asphalt from Daytona. Dang. Nice.
All generation Earnhardt.
Earnhardt's final race. Earnhardt seniors. 2001, of course. And Ralph Earnhardt.
There's some pace cars over there. A boat.
Allison. Memorial car thing. Davey died in that helicopter crash here in 93. That was kind of sad. But, there's your Davey collection. There's
Alabama Day.
There's Earnhardt. There's some older stuff if you guys were wondering. Wow, older plaques. No diecast. Entire Davey uniform Bobby. From like this man. Name. I don't know if you can read that. And there's the Coke, the Mille Yellow 500 at Charlotte Motor Speedway trophy.
I didn't see that.
No, that is how big that trophy. It looks so small in real life, but that is how big it was in the 1990 race, at least. But yeah, that's this entire case over here.
So there's a bunch of this autographs over there.
What a big old trophy there. So you get.
Can I see James Taylor?
This is probably the indie stuff. I'm not a huge indie fan, but I feel like race 2011 like that.
If this is, Rob Young will probably know who that is. Well, no, probably not.
But yeah, that's the
not
green.
An indie car,
but yeah, that's the entire case right up here. You should get a picture of, you know, when, that's the newspaper of when AJ Foyt won it. And then that iconic doors that lead to happiness.
Wow.
Bill French. And you can see him right there. The cars. You're just.
Bill French Senior building there.
Open. But I'm going to check out those cars later. Let's go to here and check out some of the pace cars in the boat first. So, should get a truck here. Official race truck. A Busch Clash one from Daytona. 1982. So yeah, that's a pretty old pace car. Iconic though. So if I see the Busch, the 1982 Daytona 500, we can just watch that. That'll be the pace car. Another Trans Am. A flipping boat. This is not just NASCAR, but it's most of it NASCAR. A airplane. And this car. Look at this. Oh shoot. There's a hot thing. I don't know what that is. I don't know whose bus that is, but thank you. Yes, you can get on the boat. Yes, you can get. You can get on the boat, or look at it at least. Engine, fire. That's a nice boat. So you see some more cars in there and more people, of course. And this one looks pretty slick and badass here. I remember this one specifically when the last went here. Some car, I don't know. It ain't old, it ain't iconic, but it's just, you know, car there. Oh, it's Bill Elliott. No. Okay, engine by Ernie Elliott. So this is a whole nother car from Georgia. And then we'll check out the airplane towards the end of the museum. That's where the end of it is. But yeah. Whew. Time to go on over here. Bill Elliott's $1 million win. What a race, jeez. Let me go back over here and take a picture of that. Bill Elliott. Now you got the Davey Allison, you know, Dutch car, but it's sharp, you know. Trying to mix Daytona with a little paint, so that's awesome. The Davey used to step. Why they got? I don't know. This is the Thunderbird owned by, you know, but that is nice. And then you got Dale Jarrett's, you know, final year car, you know, Waltrip's, you know, Michael Waltrip Racing, you know, WR, it's not eight, you know, Dale Jarrett's. So I remember watching, looking at this car. So a lot of these cars are the same, but I'm going to touch the wing because, you know, I want a full wing. Oh, my God. It's nice. Is that fiber? Yes, it's actual fiberglass, but I think it's been a great ride, Dale. Final year. Then you got just this, there's a car you can get into. There it is. This is some dude. I don't know. You can read that if you care about it. Pause the video if you need to. Okay, moving on. But yeah, that's a nice little car there. Got more cars around here. Then you see Travis over here because, you know, it's Travis.
Travis doing Travis things.
Whatever that is, you got more of that, but you can read this too.
Can you get a picture of me in here?
Yeah, give me a minute. This is the car that you can get in. Get into it. Oh, man, that's really, oh, God. Pretty bad mirror back there. Just, oh, wow. Pretty sure you can get in this thing because I'm in the house. Give me a minute. Seats are really wobbly. Ooh, dang. Dang. But yeah, that's nice. If I can get the fuck out of this thing. Oh my God. Ugh. Please feel free to sit in this car taking pictures. Let me get a picture of me in this thing. Get out of this thing. Oh, I just took pictures in it, but yeah, that's the one that you can get in. It's cut off. Well, there's the side. It's just completely stripped. But yeah, that's the inside of this thing. It's really way too low, but that's iconic 43. They're gonna show that one. Then you got this Riverside. Orange car, older one, Marty Smith's. I really want to get in these cars. Whoa! I'm not touching it, but you know, that's nice. Really low. Got all that there. But yeah. Picture of them, bunch of stuff. Then you got two. The iconic Dale Wall Trip scheme, 1977. Bertha won 12 races. So this is iconic scheme. Do you remember this one? Younger fans might not, but I think it's amazing. The hood looks beautiful. If you're watching these things at Daytona Beach, there's where, this is where, this is where Darrell Walter sat himself at and won 12 races in this thing. That's nice. There's your mirror. So they put them right up there. There's your point of view. But nice little view there. And this car. Ooh, he actually had Jesus on it, so. Let's just go show you how that though those days were different. You got this one, I don't know. It has my name all over it. But yeah, just Winston. this one, I don't know. I'm not gonna go to every one of these, but I'm gonna go to a good amount of them. But yeah, you got some red farmer colors. This looks badass, sharp. Man. Good. This one looks like a car driven that one video game, one online. Just didn't help. That's a nice one. You got Fireball Roberts. This is one that I really loved when I first went up here. This is one of my favorite ones. And whew, that seat's nice actually. It's Fireball Roberts. Car. It's a nice car. Iconic as crap. Into some of the Gen 4 era. Kevin, Happy, Harvick. You see, the seats are different than the other ones, you know. There's a radio. as you guys in the point of view side of it, cup holders for some reason. But this is a big car to get in. Little area room, all that. Respect Harvick for driving this thing. One of the iconic ones where he beat Mark Martin in one of those thriller races in this car. This is exact same primary car, not the same win. Twisted Sister effect, as you can easily see. But yeah, there's Kevin Harvick's 2007. I can get a good picture of it there, I guess. Davey Allison car. Same one like that one, but this is the one that, you know, the Winston and all that. You can see how it's different than the other ones, but it's more of a Gen 4 type era car. Even used to today, you know, mirrors in it, sadly, but.
Just
yeah.
I think Davey Allison's butt was right there before.
Yeah, exactly. Nice scheme, the iconic one. There's a slick scheme there.
This car made the thumbnail of Slatcher's video on the top 10 worst models of race cars.
Okay, let me get a picture of that. It's awesome. A nice little picture for his salute. See, tribute to Davey. One of the greatest, probably would have changed the motorsports industry if he didn't die. A little nice picture there. Bobby Allison. You know, this is one of those worst makes in NASCAR, but iconic scene in the West. Then you got them and, you know, all them. There's Darrell Waltrip in there, so, you know, that's a nice one. I'm gonna look around it by myself. Some of these cars are not gonna be in the video, so I'm sorry about that, but I know one car that will make the video, and I missed it. So, here is Harry Gant. Oh, you can tell it's right. Damage there, I don't know what tire feels. Rock. Is that his old one? Don't know why it's damaged there. Beautiful. Oh. Thirty-third of this car. Don't even look like he's got that much damage on it. Jeez. But yeah, Harry Gant's final car, and we're gonna go to the next segment of this museum. Richard Petty's nice schmexy car there. Nice car. Ooh, Alan Kowicki. 1993, the one that he died. Kind of sad, but Hall of Fame put a die cast of him here. 1992 champion, you know, a couple wins. But yeah, he was a driver, owner driver. For his own team. There's some really nice cars here. Here's just David Gilliland's 2000 and what, do they have a plate on it or no? So here's an interesting fact about this car. In October of 2006, David Gilliland timed, they was doing qualifyings, right? He had the exact same time as pole sitter Jeff Gordon. The exact same pole sitting time. It's never happened in the history of ever. He had the exact same speed as Jeff Gordon. And he ended up, Jeff Gordon ended up getting pole because he had more owner points that year. Mm-hmm. But that was wild. He had the exact same speed, exact same Talladega time as Jeff Gordon. And here's Jeffrey Earnhardt. Jeffrey Earnhardt. Oh my God, here's 8-time champion Ricky Bobby. Wow. Oh my God, Ricky Bobby. Ricky Bobby, 8-time NASCAR Cup Series champion. Yes. He's my hero. Oh my God, yes. Ricky Bobby. Ricky Bobby. Ricky Bobby, my hero. Ricky Bobby is my hero. And then you get Davey Allison. Not Davey Allison, Bobby Allison's 1988. Wasn't that the year that they finished 1-2 in the 500? I'm pretty sure. Slick car, nonetheless. 8-time champion. Oh, what a nice little car here. I ordered one of those iconic schemes there is in NASCAR, so we could picture that. And yeah, let's go on to the Intimidator, Dale Earnhardt Sr. What a more iconic driver, everything here with Dale Earnhardt. What a NASCAR driver, man. What a NASCAR driver. I don't know what year this is, but it's gotta be in the late 90s. Dale Earnhardt would sit right there. But that was a nice one. Slick one. Best scheme there is. Shiny too. Got some of that.
Oh, really?
Thought it was that same primary scheme. What a race. What a scheme. You know, Dale won a bunch of championships with that car. Most iconic race car and everything. Here goes Jeff Gordon, and that's the one I've been wanting to look at. But here we go, Jeff Gordon's 2004 Pepsi. This is the four-time champion's favorite car, 24 shards paint scheme for Talladega. Oh, that's the one that, this is the scheme. Remember when he took that one away from Junior, but what a car here, man. Get a better picture for you, Wyatt, if you watch his YouTube videos. What scheme? And we'll get on to the one I'm waiting for. We'll see. Jimmy Johnson's 2006 Daytona 500 win. Woo, I'll watch this race. Exact same tape, exact same scuffs and marks and bugs from that race in 2006. Logo there. Wicks filter, same tires, everything. Victory. Confetti. I think, yes, confetti. And what a car he would sit down in. Exact same one, Jimmy Johnson. This is the race that started the legacy of Jimmy Johnson's six-time championships. No, seven-time champion, Jimmy Johnson. This is the one that first win of the first championship, the Daytona 500 win. As you would see, that same place where the camera would be. Bunch of drivers signed, bunch of areas signed that. Favorite scheme of the 2006 season and of NASCAR ever champion, well-deserved championship, and well-deserved driver, Jimmy Johnson, won in this car. What a race, what a, just everything, man. Jimmy. And then you got Rowdy Bush, and not so iconic car. Most of these cars are the exact same ones I saw. I didn't see that Jeffrey Earnhardt there or that David Gillen when I first went here, but just Kyle Busch's 2005, you know, Kyle Busch. A lot of the new fans don't remember that when he was in this five, but nice drive for that five car this season, 2021. What a win for Rowdy. What a race, what a car for Rowdy Bush with the 88. Here's one that I feel like a lot of you guys might not know, but here's a IROC car from Kurt Busch or Kyle, I don't know, but IROC nonetheless. What a series, you know? He started one with I think this is a race one or what, but I noticed that just now. But what a race. What a scene, you know? Let's drop a 9-minute footage there. Gonna be great on me. Shut the fuck up, boys, damn. Then you got some of these, and then my boy again, Morton. Got the guy still kicking ass. Arca again. And Kyle Busch, that's one. Mark Trace Jr., Kurt Busch. Get over down here. Let's go to the top. Homestead, you know. I'm gonna try to get this all done right here. Jimmy race fan again. I don't know what race that is. Orange Row Racing, nice team out of Denver, Colorado, just trying to, you know, make himself known. You know, some more cars down there, and you got tires and Earnhardt pictures. Gordon right there, you got some of Jimmy's signing tires, you know. But that's nice. Yeah, that's all that. There it goes right there. There's a big old. I just have a bunch of pictures drawn. Drawings here, which are amazing. That one's nice. I need a picture of that one, but Dale's pretty nice there too. But you got just some random drivers up here. Let's go back over there. There's Jimmy's. Remember that for 2017. There's Dale. You know, you got a bunch of cars, drivers in here. Stewart, Brad, Andretti, Jimmy Johnson. Biffle's in there for some reason. I don't know why. That one looks nice. The Arkham and Nard series. And then right over here, we have every Arkham and Nard series champion from down. My boy, Grant, Chase Briscoe, Sheldon Creed. And then you continue to that, and there, here's the one, our hometown hero, Brett Holmes from Mumford, Alabama. Pretty nice showing, actually. I love this kid. Not a huge fan of him. He didn't really win that much, but he deserved the championship, and he won it. So Brett Holmes from this Mumford, Alabama native comes out there and wins championship. You know, awesome. See that from a local town here, you. And you get some of Davey's and Donnie's cars. And you got over here, you get some of Earnhardt stuff. There's another room back there. Oh man, that's awesome. That's the thing I want to get a picture of right there. But Dale's final win. Bunch of diecast in here too. Not for sale, sadly, because I would want to buy some of these really, really badly. Full on engine in there. Ooh, there's the fastest time, I think. I don't know. Fastest laps here. Oh, let me go check out the bathroom. Whoa, this is sad. Okay, that's just the bathrooms in here. If you want to look at the men's, I don't know, women's, I ain't going in there. Ooh, doggy, what a. This was the big one. Here, this is a Hall of Fame for every kind of series, you know, dirt, trucks. That's an old truck. Dang, it's huge. So they got some big ones in here. Got myself through here. How do you fit in those? I have no clue. When I was little, I couldn't fit in those. I'm skinny, so that just shows you. There's a whole Dale Earnhardt section back here. And they have it, Michael Waltrip's Bristol wreck right here. Oh my God, Bristol wreck, Michael Waltrip. This whole door, the seat and everything, that's just a bunch of parts there. I'm not touching it because you can honestly cut yourself on these things. Big wreck for no bonnet. Oh, that's just damage that you see on the diecast with the tackle, it's, you know, just caved in, all that broken glass. I ain't touching that. I broke my panel, some glass like that. And then there's that time when Ricky Craven's Talladega wreck. There's the inside of a NASCAR. There's
yeah, no, we're gonna have a few pictures of that. Actually got quite a lot of pictures of that.
Waltrip's
Bristol crash in
1990. You know, you got some Bobby Allison stuff from Talladega 22. Iconic stuff. Oh, that's nice, actually. I'm going to put it for that. Davey Allison right here. I feel like he would have changed the 90s forever and the sport of NASCAR forever if he, you know, actually got in there and some stuff. And here's some engines straight up in here. Bunch of stuff right here.
Did you go over to the Dale Memorial?
I'm about to go to that right now. Nice. Let's go to the Dale Earnhardt Gallery right now. See what he has in here. For. Dale Earnhardt Gallery. And you open it up with Dale's. Finally winning Daytona 500. Pictures in here. Dale Earnhardt was a living legend in the motorsport. everybody should know that by now, but there's the newspaper when he died. What, Travis? Let me get some shit done here. Dang, that's just sad right there. I don't.
This is not my romance.
That's the part where people just, that is just sad, man. Dale Earnhardt stuff. Finally a winner and all that. Let me get a picture of that. Dale Earnhardt will be a legend in a lot of people's eyes. I'm gonna go up here because they don't have anything up here, but whatever.
She make a clap. Over here?
No. There's Dale's funeral. That's Dale's funeral, I think.
There's Dale, a wicked witch, his child, and Rusty. Just look at Dale's stance.
That's memed right now. When I get up, I'm taking a shit.
Is that memed?
Father, like, son, you know. But, what a museum here. I love this place today. Is there anywhere else to go to, though? I think that's how this place ends. It ain't big, but it ain't small. I'm gonna go check out Jimmy with my other phone and all that. Eleanor would sleep here in 1994. I found out a way to piss off Bubba Wallace, make him want to kill himself. This here is the airplane that we saw. Bobby Allison's superstar Bobby flew this airplane several hundred hours to NASCAR races. Oh, nice. This was the actual airplane Bobby Allison flew to NASCAR races. How about that?
My question is, where's the landing gear at?
Ooh, that one's slick. I've always wanted to own one of these cars.
The door doesn't open.
It's just... Nut. Oh man, that's hot.
Where would the key?
And you got this one.
Where would the key?
Oh, there's no key. That's the bad part about it.
I'm going to put you guys in a point of view. Point of view, you're an IndyCar driver. Well, point of view, you're an IndyCar driver.
Jeanette and Max Pappas drove it.
Max Pappas?
Well, somebody with the last name Pappas.
Who's Pappas? That is Bobby Allison's Daytona 500 win trophy from 1981. Dang. Ooh, that is a bunch of trophies.
Why is that the Boy Scout logo?
Bobby Allison was in the Birmingham Aerial Council. Holy cow, that's nice. I think Bobby Allison was in the Boy Scouts. This is a car cut in half. Directly cut in half for this thing. Look. Look at that, man. Skeleton of the car. The engine looking beautiful as always. That's what a car looks like in half, man. There's the other side of it in the mirror. I'm talking about the main mirror. But yeah, nice museum up here in Talladega, Alabama. Not every car is gonna be cut.
Are we still
that entire hallway to go? Yeah, there's some of these. Kyle Larson, of course, his tiny ass still fit in one of these. Not surprised by anything. Congratulations. But yeah, that's a. Say so. Merry Christmas, Jacob, and
how
now.
Sure Kyle Larson fit on.
And the final.
Dale Jr.
Hallway.
The final hallway.
In
the
this
final.
Museum.
There's a bunch of ducks.
There's a bunch of ducks.
Some boots. A Dale Earnhardt diecast. Another Dale Earnhardt diecast. I have that diecast in my pocket right now.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Move aside. Why does it smell like Mitch's house?
I don't know.
Really, it does.
Daytona 500, man.
Oh, Mitch sent a New Hampshire trophy from 1999.
New Hampshire trophy.
And then some more diecast. But yeah, that's the end of the museums.
More stuff right there. Earnhardt, Neil Bonnet.
Huge diecast here. And then you just got slap in some diecast.
Okay, we just go over Kyle Petty's protest car. There's a yellow flag. There's some New Hampshire 300 tickets.
Baby, shoot, dump.
No.
Guess so much for watching this video. I'm sorry it's a little longer, but this is my Labor Day off, and I got online school tomorrow. I'm gonna do for like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, hopefully. COVID doesn't get bad, but I'm also planning on going to this one thing right here for my birthday, 15th birthday. It's the Hall of Fame thing. I don't know. Hopefully, get and go there. If I don't, I won't be mad. I think I can drive my car around Talladega. But all in all, I had a great experience in here. I've been here a couple years ago. Most of the cars are the same, but there are some newer ones I see. I remember most of those, but it's still an experience to show pictures of them. So I might not want to go back here for a good minute. Because most of those cars haven't been changed since 2018. But you never know. They might bring in something else. But the Jimmy Johnson car was my absolute favorite. Jimmy Johnson, the Daytona 500. But if you will, please leave a like, subscribe for more. Go here one day. It's in Talladega, right next to the track, actually. When you get over here, there's a track right down there. So, yeah, it's not that far. From where I live, at least. So, yeah, if you will, please consider smashing the like button and subscribing. I need to get that 400 mark. I don't know if I'm there by the time this video goes up. But, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Leave a like, subscribe for more. And until next time, have a great one.